is your EV charger just charging your car? Or is it actually doing a whole lot more than you can see? The truth is, not all EV chargers are created equal. And does having one that's connected to the internet really allow it to do that much more? If you're new here, my name's Trevor, and if not, welcome back to the channel. I helped launch 2 successful EV charging startups, and now I make videos on how it works. And I promise you, if you subscribe to this channel, you'll learn everything you need to know to stay ahead of the curve. Today, we're talking about smart chargers versus dumb chargers. We'll be talking about what they are, what the difference is, and why it's a big deal. One of my dad's favorite sayings is unburden and simplify. So if you're looking to keep it simple and stress-free, a dumb charger is the way to go. When I say dumb charger, I just mean it's not connected to the internet or non-networked. This is the official term. Non-networked chargers are simple, they're affordable, they get the job done, they're perfect for personal home use if you're just charging your car with a level 1 charger overnight. All you have to do is plug it in and your car starts charging. But the downside to non-networked chargers are their capabilities are limited. The biggest downside to a non-networked charger is it's not connected to any app. So you can't monitor anything remotely and there's no real-time updates. But playing devil's advocate, your car still has an app so you can monitor the charge through that. And this is why it works really well with personal home use. On the other hand, if you're a business or you're looking to ride into 2025 with me, then smart chargers are the way to go. I love technology. I love seeing all the new features an app can do and what's possible. I mean, yeah, eventually AI will probably take over and end humanity, but for now it's kind of fun seeing what it can do. I'm totally joking. So smart chargers or network chargers are connected to the internet. And this opens a whole new world of opportunities. The biggest feature here, and this mostly applies to businesses, is the ability to process payments. Without the internet, you can't process payments. So if you're looking to make any money from EV chargers, you'll definitely want to go with network chargers. You'll also be able to manage the chargers remotely. You can check if they're up and running properly or if they've been disconnected to the network for whatever reason. You can keep an eye on the status of each charge. You can monitor how much energy is being used. And you can even be in control of the scheduling or billing for idle fees. You'll also be gathering a lot of valuable data through the software that can be used to enhance your business. One of the coolest features is something called load sharing. It's a pretty big topic and deserves its own video, which I made a few months ago. But the whole idea is the chargers can balance the amount of energy they're using so it doesn't overload your electrical system. So for example, if you had 4 chargers and 2 are being used, then it will know to shift all the electricity over to those 2 chargers because the other 2 don't need it at the time. Essentially, it just helps you make the most of the power that you have available in the building. So I would say that in the majority of cases for home use, dumb chargers are more than enough. But if you're a business or looking to take it to the next level, then smart chargers are the way to go. If you have any thoughts, feel free to leave them in the comments below. I'm still in Brazil, so hello from São Paulo. Also, I really appreciate all my new subscribers. You guys are keeping me going. Thanks so much for checking in, and I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers. That was pretty close.